Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design an inverting amplifier with a T-network feedback circuit. This schematic represents an inverting amplifier with a T-network feedback circuit. The circuit inverts and amplifies the input signal, VI. The major benefit of this circuit is that it can provide a very high gain to the input signal without using a small R4 resistor or very large feedback resistors due to the inclusion of the T-network in the feedback. This video explains how to design this circuit using TI's OPA192 in a few easy steps. The design goal for this circuit is to convert an input voltage from negative 2.5 millivolts to positive 2.5 millivolts, to an output voltage from negative 2.5 volts to positive 2.5 volts. This design uses a plus and minus 5 volt supply and has a bandwidth of 5 kHz. The equation for VO divided by VI is the transfer function of the circuit. The transfer function is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R1 times R2 divided by R3, all divided by R4. This transfer function is derived using the equivalent resistance of R2 in parallel to R3 plus R1 divided by R4, then multiplied by the inverse of the voltage divider formed by R3 when looking from the output voltage to the input. The first design step is to calculate the gain of the input signal. The gain of the input signal is calculated by dividing the output voltage swing, VO max minus VO min, by the input voltage swing, VI max minus VI min. The required gain of the input signal is 1000 volts per volt. The next step is to calculate resistors R1, R2, R3, and R4 to set the gain calculated in the previous slide. For this design, we will select resistor R1 as 100 kiloohms, R2 as 9 kiloohms, and R4 to be 1 kiloohm. By rearranging the gain equation to solve for R3, we see that R3 is equal to R2 times R1 divided by the gain times R4 minus R1 minus R2. We calculate a value of 1 kiloohm for R3. Next, we need to calculate the capacitor, C3, to set the cutoff frequency, FP. For this calculation, we will use the equivalent resistance of the feedback resistors, REQ. REQ is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R1 times R2 divided by R3. Plugging in the resistor values to the equation, we see that REQ is equal to 1.009 megaohms. We will use REQ to calculate C3, which is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi times REQ times FP. C3 is calculated to be 31.55 picofarads. Since this is not a standard capacitor value, we will use the next closest value of 30 picofarads, as shown in the schematic. Lastly, we will verify that the OPA192 has sufficient gain bandwidth to meet the 5 kHz bandwidth requirement. For the gain bandwidth calculation, the noise gain, or non-inverting gain, is used. The noise gain NG is equal to 1 plus REQ divided by R4, and is calculated to be 1010 volts per volt. The noise gain times the bandwidth FP must be less than the gain bandwidth product of the OPA192. Since 5.05 MHz is less than 10 MHz, the OPA192 has sufficient bandwidth for this design. A DC sweep of the input voltage from negative 2.5 millivolts to positive 2.5 millivolts yields an output voltage from 2.5 volts to negative 2.5 volts. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. Running an AC sweep analysis, we find that the bandwidth of the circuit is 3.42 kHz. When designing an inverting amplifier with a T-network feedback circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, be sure to use low offset devices due to the high gain of the circuit. Next, C3 and the equivalent resistance of the feedback resistors set the inverting amplifier's cutoff frequency, FP. Finally, the common mode voltage in this circuit does not vary with the input voltage. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design an inverting amplifier with a T-network feedback circuit. please visit ti.com for additional information and resources.